Hello and welcome to this first video tutorial on the use of MS Project. So during these tutorials, the case study project from the textbook will be used. So we'll watch the entry of all of the activities and scheduling information that is inherent in this project. We will watch and demonstrate how it is implemented in MS Project. So what I'd like you to do is to start from the creation or the identification of the activities, the activity list. It's on page 51 of the textbook. But during that process, the following activities were identified. And so now the challenge is to enter those activities and other information into MS Project. So let's go over to MS Project, and we're going to bring up a blank project plan so far. So a couple of things. One is to always do a save as. This is something you should always do for your software files. Give it a representative file name. For example, I've already done this and I've called it DecoCam version 4 product launch. Okay, so that's the name I've given it. And make sure you do that and save frequently, of course. Now, the next thing to do is to go into File again, go into Options. There's plenty of options here, most of which you do not need to change. But the one that I want you to change is under Schedule, there's a selection here, New Task Created, and the default for MS Project is Manually Scheduled. I'd like you to change that to Auto Scheduled, and always do this for all of any of your schedules that you create. We are just going to work with Auto Scheduled tasks. It's much simpler to start. Manually scheduled tasks complicate things. There is a purpose for them, but it's beyond the scope of what we're doing here. So just do that. You'll see down here, it reminds you that any new tasks are auto scheduled. So if you do that, things will be much, much simpler. Next, before we get started, another important thing to do for each schedule is to click on the project tab here, and then select project information. And this is information that is true for the overall project. And one of the key thing that you want to update is the project start date. You can see that right now the start date is assumed to be the current date. And this is rarely the case. It's just the best assumption MS Project can make. But instead, this start date of the project is normally either in the past, in that the project's already started, or it's in the future. It will start at some point soon, but it's very uncommon for it to be today. So from the textbook, the project start date is March 23rd, 2020. So you select that there, keep the current date the way it is. All the other options stay the same. Press OK, and now the project is assumed by MS Project to start on March 23rd, 2020. So now we can just start to enter the activities. And again, it's those ones that we just looked at in the textbook. Now, it's usually the project manager will have an idea of sort of what's coming first and what's coming second. We're going to talk about dependencies and the order in our next video, but that's something that you're generally getting an idea of. So I'm going to enter them in their logical order, or at least close to it. And one of the activities, or the first activity, is initiate the project. So I just go under task name, enter initiate the project, press enter. Now, a few things you'll notice. One is this is automatically scheduled, which is good. That's what we said. You'll see that the task name is there. We just entered it. There's this interesting thing where it's one day question mark. And what that means is that this is the duration column, the amount of time, elapsed time that the activity or task is assumed to take or is estimated to take. And right now, MS Project doesn't know what that is. So it just puts 1 day question mark, which means don't know. You can see it assumes it's going to start on the project start date and finish at the end of that 1 day. You can see over here in the Gantt chart area, there's a bar showing Monday. So what you should do is to update the duration that it should be. Now, it just happens to be 1 day. But what I would suggest is don't leave the question mark. That just looks odd. So there's a couple of ways you can do it. One is you can go up and then go down. And you see the way that gets rid of the question mark. The other way you could have done it was just to put a one in there. Days are the assumed duration types and press enter. So that will work. Okay, so now we've got a 1 day duration activity. Now the next one is plan the project. And that also, you can see that it also assumes 1 day. Now in this case, planning the project through our duration estimating, or that what we saw in the textbook is planned to be 7 days. So again, we can do it one of two ways. We can just go like that, or we could have just put a seven in. Either way will work. Okay. So then we're going to continue on. We have the next one, create sign graphics / text. Okay, and that one was 3 days. So we'll just put in 3. The next one is order banner stands. I believe that one was 1 day. So again, let's get rid of that question mark. Then we've got create holographic cards and order cards. That's as far as we'll go for now. Create holographic cards and order cards. And if we take a look, that's 2 days and 1 day. So 2 days, 1 day, and so on. You just keep doing that through all of them. Now, notice these bars here, they're all assumed to be starting on March 23rd. That's not the case. We will fix that later. For now, don't worry about it. It looks like a histogram, sort of a sideways one. But just let that build. You're kind of ignoring the stuff on the right side at this point. Now, we want to be able to also structure the project. Right now, this is just a list of activities. And this is okay if you only had 5 or 6 or 10, but if you had 100 activities, it would get really, really messy. So it's useful to be able to structure your schedule. Now there's two different things I'm going to show you. One is there is something called, if we go under the format tab, there's something called the project summary task. And if we turn that on, what that does is it creates a summary task for the entire project, and it's automatic. You don't have to create, you just have to click that box there. Now we're just going to increase the length of the, or the width of that a little bit so we can see the whole thing. It took the file name as its name. If you don't like that, you can change it. So we could change that to something else. So if we wanted to say, you know, launch project, we could. Okay, so I'm not going to, but we could if we wanted to. Okay, so that's something we can do. Now what we want to do is to start to structure these. And again, it seems kind of odd, there's only 5 of them, so there's not a great need to structure them, but again, imagine there's going to be more. So we want to do that. Now one of the things we want to do, and what's common on schedules, is to structure by phase. So initiating, planning, executing, closing, that's very common. So one of the things we can do is to say, okay, if we want to insert a task between these two, above one right now. So if we click on task, click on task again, and again, A new task is created. So we're going to create something called initiating. Spell it right. Okay. Now this is this isn't a real task. There's not work called initiating. It's a phase. So the way you signify to MS Project that it is a summary, you indent what's below it. So we're going to select that. Again, we're under the task tab. Click right. And now what you can see happened is initiating is bolded. This one's indented, and this information is automatically calculated. You never have to change. The only thing you can change is the name. Don't change the dates or the duration. It inherits that from what's below it. Now, likewise, plan the project. We would like to have a planning phase summary task. So we'll insert a task there. And we'll call that planning. Okay, now one of the things that is a sort of a feature of MS Project, it doesn't always work the way you want it, is that it will add a new, whenever you insert a new task, it adds it at the indentation of the one above it. Now in this case, it's too far indented. We want to outdent it. So we will go like that. Now, inside planning is this one activity called plan the project. So we will indent that, and that makes planning a summary task. We're just going to continue that process. We're going to insert executing here. Again, it's going to go at the wrong level. So we're just going to outdent that. And we're going to indent everything that is an executing task, which are all of these, and we will indent those. Now, one more feature regarding summary tasks, you can put summary tasks within summary tasks for further structuring. So for example, underneath, as part of executing, trade show signage is a summary of these two. These two activities are what's known as trade show signage. So if we, again, insert, enter trade show signage, and then we can grab both of those and push them to the right. That's now created a summary task that includes these two. Now, we're not going to continue this whole process. This will take a while. So let's look at what it looks like after you've done everything. So this is now if we would have taken the time to create the entire schedule. So you can see this is what we've done so far. This should be familiar, the planning, the executing. But watch now, executing has within it the following summary tasks, which are trade show signage, booth giveaways, multimedia demo, social media, oops, I didn't close that, website updates, media outreach, a press release, and promotional video. Oops, I'm having trouble closing that one. It's tricky. And then there's closing, which consists of one activity, close the project. So, you know, each of these, if we just start to open them back up, sometimes it's tricky to do. You can see the actual activities. Again, just to review, you don't change the durations or anything here at all. That's automatically calculated. It just takes the largest. You can see that's one on what's underneath here. It's just taking the largest of those three, and we'll look at that in more detail. Okay, so this is the place we're going to stop in this video. We will continue on from this point in our next video.